Good afternoon, children. In our previous class, we started the lesson, The First War of Independence of 1857. In that, we were reading causes of the revolt, why this revolt was started. We all know this revolt was started on 10th May 1857 at Meerut Cantonment, and this revolt is also known as Sepoy Mutiny, the uprising, first war of independence, and so on. Many other names are also there. In causes of the revolt, in our previous class we read about political causes, in that doctrine of lapse, then economic causes, various types of land revenue settlements were also there. Then now today we have to read about social and religious causes. Social means those causes which were related to our society, and religious means those causes which were related to our religion. The social reformers by the British started various reforming socially, means social reforms. They started removing the evils from our society. At that time, so many evils were prevalent in our society, like sati pratha, then ban on widow remarriage, then child lack of female child education. And Britishers started stopping these types of evil practices in our society with the help of educated Indians. But the social reforms by the British were considered an interference in the custom and traditions of the Hindus. Many orthodox Hindus, they took it as an interference, and they thought that why Britishers would interfere in our customs and traditions of Hindus. Many Indians opposed the introduction of Western education. British introduced Western education that was limited up to elite class of the society. Western education, English education, and many Indians opposed the introduction of Western education and the conversion of Indians to Christianity. Britishers gave various types of attractions to our lower caste. We all know our society was divided into four castes. Caste-ridden society was in India, and those four castes were Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. Brahmins and Kshatriyas were enjoying the position of respect, but the Vaishyas and Shudras' conditions were not good, especially Shudras. They had to serve the upper three classes, and that's why to those Shudras, Britishers gave various types of attractions so that they could join Christianity, Christian religion, and it was opposed by many Indians. Then Hindu law of property. Hindu law of property was that if any Hindu was changing his religion from Hindu to Christianity, means according to Hindu law, if any Hindu changes his religion into Christianity, then he was not entitled to get share in his paternal property or in his ancestral property. But the Britishers changed this law, Hindu law of property. And the Hindu law of property was changed to enable a Christian convert to receive his share of ancestral property. Means if any Hindu was changing himself into Christianity, then also he was entitled to get a share of ancestral property, his paternal property. So it was also opposed in the society. Then the spread of railways. We all know Britishers introduced railways in 1853. And in railway compartment, both the upper caste and the lower caste had to sit together. We Indians were conservative that time and it was opposed by many orthodox Hindus. Spread of railways created further fear among the poor and illiterate sections of the society. Literate sections of the society was knowing that it is ultimately helpful for us also. But the illiterate sections of the society, they were very much afraid of it, that they would lose their caste. Their thinking was, if they would sit with lower caste, then they would lose their caste. Then Indians were not allowed to travel in first class train compartment. First class was the highest class of train compartment that time, and where only Europeans were allowed. Indians were not allowed to travel in first class train compartment. So the conservative Indians were alarmed by the rapid spread of Western culture and English education in India. They conservative Indians, they did not like English education or Western education. Moreover, the British looked down upon Indians and followed a policy of racial discrimination. Britishers were thinking themselves superior. Why they were thinking themselves superior? Because of their skin color. Racial means skin color, based on skin color. As they were fair, so they were thinking themselves superior, and they followed a policy of racial discrimination. We Indians were black people, so British looked down upon Indians. They considered themselves as superiors. Why they considered themselves as superiors? Because of their skin color. Skin color was white and we Indians were black, so we were considered by them as inferiors. They advocated a judicial system based on the principle of equality, but in actual practice it was biased. Means judicial system was also biased. Biased means it was favoring whom? To the Britishers. So these all were the reasons behind social and religious causes. And one more was that rumors. Rumor means, you know, the false news which is spread quickly. Rumors created panic also. One such rumor was that the whole Indian population would lose their caste, as the British had sent cartloads of bone dust. It was there that bone dust cartloads are there, and it is mixed with flour and sweets that was being sold in the market. And bone dust means from the animal's bone. And that's why this rumor created panic, that the whole Indian population would lose their caste. So in social and religious causes, these were the causes. Now we will see the next cause of 1857 revolt. And the next cause was military causes. Military means you must be knowing, related to army, related to soldiers. We all know this revolt is also known as Sepoy Mutiny. Why this revolt is known as Sepoy Mutiny? Because it was started by the soldiers. Where it was started? At Meerut cantonment. The sepoys, sepoys means I have told you the soldiers, they had helped the British to establish their empire in India. But instead of receiving awards or promotions, they were humiliated by the British. Although they helped the British in expanding their territory in India, but they did not get any award or any promotion, but humiliation was there. They were humiliated by the British, and there was discrimination between the Indian and the British soldiers. Means in military and cause, military causes, we can write discrimination. Discrimination between whom? Between the Indian, between the Indian and the British soldiers. Between the Indian and British soldiers. The highest pay given to an Indian sepoy as Subedar was less than the minimum pay of a European recruit. Means a European soldier who recently joined, he was also getting more salary than the highest pay given to an Indian sepoy. Means where was the discrimination? In the salary was less. Indian sepoys were getting less salary. Then the act of 1857 made it compulsory for new Indian recruit to serve overseas means in European countries, and it hurt the feelings of the soldiers as Hindus believed that overseas travel would lead to the loss of caste. Means if they would travel overseas, then they would lose their caste. And it was introduced by Act of 1856, and in this act it was made compulsory for new Indian recruit to serve overseas. And it hurt the feelings of the soldiers. As why did it hurt the feelings of the soldiers? Because Hindus believed that overseas travel, means if they would travel to European countries, then it would lead to the loss of caste. Then Indian sepoys promotion was also restricted. Salary was less. Promotion was also restricted to the post of Subedar only. So because of all these reasons, Indian soldiers were getting less salary, discrimination was between Indian and the British soldier, promotion was restricted, and as per the Act of 1856, it was made compulsory for new Indian recruit to serve overseas. It hurt the feelings of the soldiers as Hindus believed that overseas travel would lead to the loss of caste. So in military causes, we can write this. Now the very important cause of 1857 revolt we will discuss. And that very important cause of 1857 revolt was immediate causes. Means this revolt was planned to start on 31st May, but it was started on 10th May. Why? Because of this immediate cause only. So what was immediate cause? The cartridges. Cartridges means you must be knowing, children, the bullet which is to be fit into any gun or rifle. So one new rifle Britishers introduced. That rifle was Enfield rifle. What was the name of that rifle? Enfield rifle. Britishers introduced in Enfield rifle, and in this rifle the cartridges, means the bullets of the new Enfield rifle, had a greased paper cover. Means the cartridges were greased with the fats of cows and pigs, and the soldiers had to bite the cartridges with their teeth before fitting it into the rifle. So as the cartridges were greased with the fat of cows and pigs, and we all know Hindus considered cow as our mother and Muslims hate pigs, so it hurt the sentiments of Muslim and Hindus, both the soldiers, because the soldiers had to bite off the cartridges with their teeth before fitting it into the rifle. And this cartridges of the new Enfield rifle had a greased paper cover which had to be bitten off before the cartridges was loaded into the rifle. And it was said that the grease composed of beef and pig fat. Beef means cows and pig fat. Both the Hindus and the Muslims refused to use them, as the cow is sacred to the Hindus and the pig is detestable to the Muslims. So both the soldiers started revolting that they would not use it. Then comes Mangal Pandey. Mangal Pandey was a sepoy in which cantonment? Barakpur. Where is Barakpur? In West Bengal near Calcutta. On March 29, 1857, at Barakpur near Calcutta, Mangal Pandey, a young Indian sepoy from Bengal regiment, refused to use the greased cartridges and shot down his sergeant. Sergeant means the British officer. He was arrested, tried and executed. Executed means he was hanged till death. When this news spread, many sepoys started the revolt. Now you just try to understand what was the immediate cause of this revolt. Immediate cause of this revolt was the introduction of Enfield rifle. Britishers introduced Enfield rifle. And in this Enfield rifle, the cartridges which were to be used in this rifle, those cartridges were greased. Greased means, you know, a type of fat which is put onto any object to make it slippery so that it could fit easily in this rifle. Those cartridges were greased with fats of cow and pigs, and both the Hindus and the Muslim soldiers refused to use them because cow is sacred to the Hindu and the pig is detestable to the Muslims. Then on March 29, 1857, at Barakpur near Calcutta, Mangal Pandey, a young Indian sepoy, he was a young Indian soldier. From which regiment? He was from Bengal regiment. And he refused to use the greased cartridges to fit into Enfield rifle. And he shot down his sergeant. As a result, what happened? He was arrested by the Britishers. He was tried and then he was given the punishment of execution. He was hanged till death. And when this news spread, many sepoys started the revolt. That's why this revolt is known as sepoy mutiny. So children, these were the causes of the revolt. We have already read about which causes? Political causes, economic causes, then socio and religious causes, then military causes, and then immediate causes. In political causes, what we read? Britishers introduced various types of policies like doctrine of lapse introduced by Dalhousie, according to that if any king dies without leaving his natural son or daughter, then his kingdom would automatically become the part of British kingdom, and Britishers joined various territory on that plea only. So the rulers were against this. Then in economic causes, we have already read that Indian wealth was draining to England. Then various types of taxes, various types of land revenues were introduced. Our traditional handicraft industries were destroyed by the Britishers, and it annoyed the Indian artisans also, peasants also. They joined this revolt. In political causes, their policy annoyed the rulers, so rulers joined the revolt. Now, in socio and religious causes, today we have read Western education Britishers introduced, and this Western education was opposed by the conservative Indians. So they were against the Britishers. Then Hindu law of property was changed. According to Hindu law of property, any converted Hindu who has been converted into Christianity was not entitled to get the benefit of or to get the share of his in his ancestral property. But the Britishers changed this Hindu law of property, and according to the new law, the converted Hindus, the Hindus, those were converted into Christianity, they were also entitled to get their share in their ancestral property. Then racial discrimination was there. Britishers were thinking themselves superiors, and because of their skin color, they were white, so they were thinking themselves superior. We were black, so they were considering ourselves inferior. Then judicial system was also biased. It was favoring Britishers. So it was social and religious causes. In military causes also we have read, there was the discrimination between Indian and the British soldiers. Their salary was less. Means Indian highest salary was less than the Britishers' lowest salary. Then the promotion of Indian soldiers. Indian soldiers always helped the Britishers, but they did not get any reward, any increment, and their promotion was also restricted up to the post of Havaldar only. And as per the Act of 1857, it was made compulsory that any Indian new soldier had to serve overseas. And the conservative soldiers, they thought that they would lose their caste if they traveled to overseas. Then comes immediate cause. What was the immediate cause? Introduction of Enfield rifle. And in this Enfield rifle, the cartridges were greased with the fats of cows and pigs, and the soldiers had to bite off that cartridges with their teeth before fitting it into rifle. So cow is sacred for the Hindus, and Muslims, they hate pigs, and that's why it hurt the sentiments of Hindu soldiers also, as well as Muslim soldiers also. And Mangal Pandey, a young boy in Bengal regiment at Barakpur near Calcutta, on 29th March 1857, he refused to use this Enfield rifle, and he shot down his sergeant, his British officer. As a result, he was tried, he was arrested, he was tried, and he was given the punishment of execution. So children, these were the causes of 1857 revolt. Why the revolt of 1857 was started. In our next class, we will read about course of the revolt. But your today's homework is one map pointing. Listen, the map pointing of this lesson is very important. One map pointing is given on page number 128. That page number 128 map pointing, you have to do it. This is your homework, map skill of page number 128. This is your homework. You do it. If you don't get Indian map, then you can draw it. You locate the main centers of revolt, and this map pointing is very important. And then you submit this map pointing on our WhatsApp group. That's all for today. Goodbye.